different is obviously this year, I've taken the role of being a leader. Last year was like my first year playing college basketball. I was just learning. And so whatever experience I had last year, I'm able to teach the young guys.
Things real felt real fast paced at the beginning of the year, you know, just being a freshman and like learning how to play with other people and stuff like that. From being in high school, being a man, and being able to do whatever I want to knowing how to manage the game now.
The difference in conference play is teams know you much better, and that's especially true the second time through the conference, you know, when you play them for the second time. So the attention to detail and the scouting is much more, and you have to be a little bit more conscious of diversifying, you know, what you run. But that's the biggest difference, is scouting is, I think, much more intense.
We're down here, go Bells out. Down here on the baseline. Is scout team out here? No, I'm sorry, team one out here, my fault, one more thing, team one out here. See, I did this a little bit, but I just want to make sure we're sharp. I don't think we're going to see much zone tonight, but Akron has a zone that they play. It's really the same zone Valpo played. It's a what we would call a 1-1-3 or 2-3, but their wings get really lifted. If we see them go zone, we automatically go rover. We do what we always do in rover. You're posting up, we're trying to get the ball into the five man. Their zone is spread out. They'll really kind of extend it. You guys are going logo, but we have to make sure we use the corner. Guys that cut through, you have to make sure the ball hits sideline, middle, sideline, and then we're still getting the ball inside. But don't just keep the ball up in here. Make sure that Mark's a great cut for you. Wing, really hard pass, cuts in the corner, cuts the ball there. Great, you're going to take a dribble, mount the logo, mount the show. And if you see it go zone, if I don't call a set play, we have all. We got blocks pushed through, we got flip, we got one double, we got one eagle, we got all of them. But if I don't call play, it happens fast, we automatically flow into rover. Let's go, Rover.
One of the things that we've been trying to address is letting bad plays multiply. You know, we turn the ball over, we make a mistake or do something that's not a positive play, and we start to hang our heads, or we let the plays multiply into two or three or four.
If something go wrong, not being stuck on what just happened, just being able to go to the next play, and if I have a good play or a bad play, don't let the next play affect it.
In trying to have a real next play mentality where, hey, good play, bad play, to stay focused on the next play and stay positive and you know, there's a time to correct the mistakes, but right after it happens, not the time.
It's been a big challenge because obviously I've never been in that situation before. Like, it's my second year playing college basketball, so I'm still learning. So something I got to get better at. So, but overall, it's a good role to be in.
Back on the clear out, sure. You're pushing in back. We know they run clear on inside of bounds. It's their most frequent play. They run it more than anything else. You're pushing in back on the loaded side. They can shoot tough twos. Defense off. Got two more.
Here we go. Let's go this
time. Four.
Go.
Get loose. Go ahead, dribble flip. Here's how it's looking. Good. I let him get it. I come. Don't go too early because you're not going to go too early if I screen, right? You got to act like good. Wait for me. And then I'm sprinting here. I got to take off and be gone. You're trying to keep.
Really have everybody really going at each other, being really competitive, fast, super fast pace, up and down, talkative. Everything is really, really fast, like running fast and with a fast tempo. So. It's really a competitive practice.
See, he's going to come off, act like he's throwing it to you. He's going to back that because I know they're going to deny some, so we're going to get to this some tonight. Reject. If you got it. Flip ends and you're going to skip past you. Because in particular, although they run four or five plays out of it, what does Treadwell love to do? Loves to pop. So if I plug and he comes off, it's just like clear. I plug. Go ahead. My angle is cutting off the drive in there. perimeter guys, I got these shooters. Wiley, Diggs, McNabb, Kretzer. I got these shooters wide. What is my job? Help is in now. My help is in early, but as he drives, if I run right here.
I feel like he pushes me way past where I can be pushed sometimes, and sometimes I don't want to hear him talking like that, but he just keep talking, keep pushing me to I'm gonna just get to learn and not have a freshman mindset.
Picks up his dribble, I recover so I'm able to guard my man one-on-one. Shrink the floor, guard your guy, and drive it.
I'm not judging our season based on wins and losses. I don't want them to judge the season based on wins and losses. If we play really well, that's a good thing. Sometimes we win those games, sometimes we not. If we play Kentucky at Kentucky, we can play really well and not win. You know, I can't beat ourselves up over that. For us, it's about the process. It's about being able to watch our team and say, can we execute our system and our style of play in a difficult environment? We could play a bad team, win by two, and not play well. I'm not happy with that. You know, I'm only judging us by ourselves and the things that we need to do to get better. I think that's where all of our focus has to be.
I don't make you soft on ball screen defense. Because when we're soft on ball screen defense, we don't play good. That's clear to me after watching us for 10 games. When we're at our best, we're in attack mode, we got attack. Protect that rim. The only thing you're doing different than any other game is that horns ball screen. That horns ball screen, because we're going to play unclear. They set a side ball screen, Jook, Ding, Bo, anyone else, you attack. I want two guys on the ball from Marcus up and tell you. When I watch us play in practice and I watch us every day, we're getting better. We're learning how to play better. We're getting tougher. We're learning our system and our style much more. We're going to play our best game of the year tonight.
All in on three. One, two, three.
All in.
Six games in a row. To me, I would look at our team and say four games in a row we've done it. We really have. The one thing we can control and we have to control tonight, we've got to be the hardest playing team out there. That's completely within us and our will to do it. Run hard, foul line to foul line, loose balls. I was more proud of our team in the second half of James Madison maybe than I was all year. It was like a loose ball bonanza out there and it really changed the game. It felt right for us out there. I want us to play really hard. I want us to be these every single time we play. I want us to be the hardest playing team in the conference. And the great thing about tonight's game, that's who they've been for 8 years in a row. You guys in this league know that. That's their identity. That's their mantra. We're trying to take it from them. Got to be the hardest playing team. 10 4-minute wars. Don't think about 40 minutes. Think about four at a time. Play really hard. We do this. And we do this, fellas, we're going to win the game. And I mean that. What we can control is how hard we play. Let's make sure when we leave this 40 minutes, we can look at each other and say, fellas, that's the hardest we've played all year. That's what I'm asking.
All in on three. One, two, three.
All in.
Thank you.
coming back into this game, having down to a 4-point game, he hits a shot at the end, makes it a 6-point game. Now, you guys know it like I know it. What's biggest difference for us was our effort, though. All of a sudden, loose balls and energy and all that kind of guys fighting inside, rebounds between guys diving on the floor, guys hustling like crazy. That was the biggest difference in the game. Our communication on the floor started to be like the communication on the bench. That's why that thing got back down to 4. And like every time we play well, we started to score in transition and really attack in transition. Now, here's what I would tell you. I'm gonna go our defense first because it's the most important thing for us to win this game, is getting stops, post catches. Post guys, I think you're doing a good job. I mean, Treadwell right now, it's a little bit like what we talked about. Treadwell's 1-for-7 from the field. That's their money guy in the post. He's not killing us. Treadwell's 1-for-7. They're not killing us off of throwing that ball into 15 feet. You guys are battling. We've done a good job. We prepared it. In the first 4 minutes, our guys that were crowding solely were looking at their guy, at the ball. We had no idea who was out there, and they threw it out. They missed a couple wide open shots in there. Got way too good a look by throwing the ball inside out. Our big guys got to stay fight and got to keep staying on the top side. The other thing that's bugging us is middle ball screen with Quincy Diggs. And I'm going to tell you two things. He's taking 11 shots in 11 minutes right now. Sometimes that 4 is going to plug and sometimes that 4 is going to jump based on what he's doing. But the guy guarding the ball is going under, and the reason he's going under is because we're playing so far off of him. It's like we're scared of him. Don't go under the ball screen. Don't go under it. You got to stay, got to guard him, got to guard him, got to pressure him. You know what? He makes a lot of plays. You know who he makes a lot of plays for? Their team and the other team. Dude turns the ball over like crazy. In there. He's always trying to make plays, but if you're guarding Quincy Diggs, it's in a stance. Don't go under ball screens. If it's a plug or a jump, you're on his hip. You're getting a go. You got to get a fast warm-up, but I'm telling you this. You sense this. This is our game. Got to be the harder playing team in the second half. Play the hardest in this game.
Give it to you. Let's go.
1, 3. 1, 2, 3.
All right. Let's go. Compete, man. Compete.
Keep going, baby.
Head up across the board. Like I always say, that hurts. It hurts everybody. It hurts me as much as anyone in this room. I'm proud of us in a lot of ways because I'm no longer out there fighting about effort. Barring there's 6 or 8 minutes a game where I'm saying, fellas, that's not the fight we have to have. But when I was one time coming up in here from a non-negotiable standpoint, I'm not doing that anymore. We out-rebounded them. That's the best rebounding team in the league. You look at the hustle stats, our hustle stats are good. We don't have a problem there. Not that we can't get better, because I want to be the hardest playing team in the league every single time we play. That's our goal across the board. We have to get better from an execution standpoint. But as we go further into the year, we have to be able to make those connections so we can look at it and say, Coach, this never, ever went away. And by the way, here, we're getting a lot better. We're getting a lot better. I don't care what they do to us, we can run Carolina. I don't care what they do to us, we can run Phoenix. And when we start putting these two together, you're going to feel real good. Because everyone in this room knows we can be a lot better than we were here tonight. Collectively, some individually, coaches, you name it, we all have to get better. And that, we win as a team and we lose as a team every game, no matter what. But this area can get a lot better. If this area was a lot better, I didn't think that score would have been tonight. You would have liked how you felt.
you would have liked how you felt. What I always say, our goal, which is a realistic, achievable goal, is to be playing the best of our ability, maximizing our potential here and here when we hit February and March and say, fellas, we have a chance to win. We have a chance to beat Akron. We got a chance to beat OU. We have a chance to beat Toledo because we can do both things. We can. We've come a long way here. A long way. We're getting better here, not fast enough. We'll have the film broken down by tomorrow. We all have to look at each other and learn our lessons across the board. And then make sure we have great practice Thursday, great practice Friday. When we go to Kent State, I will always care about this more than I care about this. I care about both. But I'll always care about this more than anything else. Because if you want to do what we're trying to do, that's what's going to get us there. All right? Fellas, that's it from my end. Now, this is a long year. We got 18 of these things. Take care of your body. If you didn't play well, reload on fluids. Get your rest. Get a good night's sleep. Make sure when you come back here tomorrow, we can all have an honest look at each other and say, hey, this is what we have to get better at. If we do these things, we're going to flip these scores. And have a great practice tomorrow. Great one Friday. We're on the road. All right? All right, fellas.
Hey, stay together.
Why
lose? All
in on three. One, two, three.
All in.
Akron, I thought we really defended well. We put together some great stops. Sometimes, you know, when things don't go well for you offensively, you can kind of lose your effort on defense. I thought we really stayed tough and strung together significant stops in a row, and eventually when our offense broke through, we were still in the game. So I was pleased with our team's effort. Akron's a really good team, and, you know, we were right there to win it. We have some guys on our team that I think are real competitors. You know, they just have a real fiber in their body. They love to compete. And so I think you've seen that personality here at home a lot, you know, where we've gotten down or things have gone well or not well, and we have found a way of clawing back. But in terms of teaching our guys to stay with the process, you know, it's really been a little bit of blind faith.
Keep it out. Good job, Joe. Crouch. Crouch. Stay down. Good job, Jesse. Come on, D up. See it. See it. Sink, Franco. Frank. Sink. Sink.
Talked about before the Buffalo game of staying positive and having a deep-rooted belief that if you continue to work hard and do things right, that eventually the ball is going to bounce your way.
There you go, White. Good. I'm telling you, we had back-to-back great possessions. You shoot it, you're wide open, you shoot it. Now you know the trap. Great shot. Shot prep, you keep shooting that thing, we're going to be in great shape. Good flow, 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 flow. Pat the head. So, just got a minute and a half. I'm gonna keep doing like always. You got your normal rotation. Great job. Great job. Let's go D up. KD, take care of the ball. Get it out of your hands. Let us run passing game.
Oldham brings it up the floor for Buffalo. He's going to take it on his own. Three from the right wing. No good. Rebound to McCray. Back out to Love for three. No good, and the Cardinals win! Ball State knocks off the Buffalo Bulls in Worthen Arena, 71-68. Wow, what a ball game!
Fellas, bow your head.
It's about the process, and that's true whether you're, whatever your record is. I think for any team in the country, whether you're Alabama football or Ball State basketball, you know, it's what we got to do is put this one behind us and make sure that, and I think it, yeah, obviously it helps to feel good. We haven't had enough of that, but it's end of the day, we practice here in 30 minutes, and it's about having a great practice and being able to lock in mentally on the next game.
We played really good basketball tonight for a lot of the game. We certainly made our mistakes like we did every game. I'm going to tell you this. There's been many other games where we have played really good basketball, but you know what the difference was tonight, between tonight and those nights?
We didn't have that. We didn't have
that. We didn't let bad plays affect us near as much. They had a little four-row run. We were able to go next play. Second half, we came out. Fellas, we're playing. You know, when we have a fast push into Phoenix, that's how we want to play. That's when we're at our best. I said at the end, don't play not to lose. Play to win. You play to win. I was glad you attacked that dude and took it under the rim. I was glad. I want you to play that way. Play to win.
Everybody played hard. Everybody was playing to win, not to lose. And now we just got to keep playing hard, and because we can beat any team in the league. So we just got to have that in our minds every time we play, and just give it our best.
I couldn't be more happy. You guys have worked really hard. I told you before this deal, I thought the last two practices were outstanding. Jesse, the elephant in the room.
Jesse played really well last night against Buffalo. And, you know, he not only did it on the offensive end, but Jesse really defended the best that I've seen him defend since I've been here. And we need that kind of effort from him, both on offense and defense, because we're a much better basketball team when he's playing with great energy.
You great today? Now, here's the thing. I'm going to tell you, with practice and everything, it's got to be an everyday thing. Because there's a standard is the standard. Standard is the standard for you. The standard is the standard for you. The standard is the standard for you, for you. And by the way, if Bonzi Wells was sitting right here, the standard is the standard for him. That's how good teams become good teams.
It's a huge relief, you know. Guys are really confident now. And, you know, we felt like the weight's not on our shoulders anymore, but the weight's still on our shoulders because we ain't achieving like we should be in achieving. So it just feels better to get a win. You know, guys are happy and stuff like that, and we're all confident right now.
There's a way you go about your business. Got to have it every single day. You had two great days of practice. When you come in tomorrow, I expect it to be great across the board. Fellas, great win, man. Enjoy it. Enjoy it. Really good win. I'm proud of everybody. It was a complete team effort. Want you to feel good about it.
Going to practice every day, having a real good practice. As you know, we've been having good practices week by week by week. It's progressing and stuff like that. So, you know, we finally bust through and get a win. So if we keep having good practice, good things are continuing to happen.
We know it was a very big win for our team because we haven't won a game in a long time. And we've been just working hard, pushing through.
Confidence has grown as individually and as a team. You know, guys don't care about scoring or getting their numbers.
And hopefully it's just the beginning of us getting a lot more wins.
Fellas, I'm proud of you, man. That's all I got to say. Really good win. Right, let me say one more thing. Anyone know where Buffalo's picked to win in this league? They're picked second. They're picked second in the East. So in terms of where we can be as a team, that team is at the top. When we play well, we can beat good teams. That's crystal clear. Got to stay with it. Good job.
You're good,
though. Yes.
One, two, three.